Sporting KC is playing right now, but they're losing 1-0 at half. So go Sporting. They need to win because they dropped into second place last night. Royals had a 4-0 lead yesterday, but they didn't at the end. So they're playing my friend Father Bart's favorite baseball team, who's from Wisconsin. So go Royals, beat those Brewers. And then the Chiefs play tomorrow. So good luck to our local teams. All right, PSR registration forms are now available online. Well, they've been available, that's not new. Let's see. PSR starts tomorrow morning, Sunday morning. So if you have kids or grandkids, that starts tomorrow morning. We're also going to have a blessing of all the catechetical teachers, since this is a catechetical weekend. So that will be after the homily. The United States Conference of Catholic Bishops has established an emergency disaster fund to finance assistance efforts for those afflicted by disasters, such as Hurricane Laura. We've also have Hurricane Sally. We've got a few more hurricanes coming, but we're not going to have a special collection for that. But if you do want to donate for all emergency disaster funds through the Catholic bishops, just mark on your check emergency disaster fund, okay? There is a second collection today for the Church in Latin American Appeal, so please place all your envelopes, regular and the special collections, in the baskets in the aisles, okay? All right, so Susan's going to have an announcement about where to find music, but if you wear your mask, you can sing. But if you don't have your mask on while you're in the pews, then you cannot sing, okay? But if you want to sing, put your mask on, okay? I just lip sync anyway, so if you see me without my mask, there's nothing coming out, okay? All right, birthdays. Do we have any birthdays? Right here. When's your birthday? Today? Happy birthday. Any others? Back here? Tomorrow, happy birthday to you. Others? Back here? One and be 1 year old on the 28th. Happy birthday early. Is that it? Anniversaries. Back here, Anita. How many years? 57 Monday. Happy anniversary. All right, is that it? Where's all the Radicans? There's Radicans. There's a lot of birthday Radicans. Are they coming tomorrow, some of them? Oh, yeah, that's true. All right. Susan is going to talk about music.
As you heard Father say, we now have the go-ahead to sing when we're in the pew. So I have this announcement regarding that. I'd like you to take out your phone. This is the one time in church, well, actually, now all the time in church, you're welcome to take out phones. Or if you have a tablet at home and you're going to be here next weekend, bring your tablet with you, because this is how you will access the words and the music to the songs that we're doing at this Mass. So we encourage you to join in singing at Mass while you wear your mask. You may find the words and music for songs used at Mass by using your phone or tablet, which you may take out now. You can use your browser. So if you have Safari or Google or Chrome that you use to get on the internet, open that up, and then you're going to go to our parish website. It's stsabinaparish.org. It's stsabinaparish.org. No spaces. Now, if your phone is like mine, my reception, it takes a while for anything to open up. So don't worry if it doesn't open up right away. You have the whole Mass to get it open. And when it opens, you'll see the home page of the website. Toward the right side, you'll see a row of three blue buttons. At the bottom, there's two half-sized blue buttons. One will say, Worship Aid, 4 p.m. and 10:30 Mass. If you click that, it will open up a PDF file for you, and it will have, it's just like a program, but it's on your phone or tablet instead of being paper. We still can't pass out paper, you know, passing things from hand to hand. So this is our solution for now. We're working on multiple solutions, but this is what we got together for this weekend. Okay, so one more time, it's www.stsabinaparish.org, no spaces. And the blue button that says Worship Aid, 4 p.m. and 10:30 a.m. Did it open for anybody yet? Has anybody got it? Oh, we have a winner. Okay, so if you're patient, it will eventually open. Now you know this, and it will be the same way every weekend. If you want to download that at home, when you're on your network at home, and download that PDF for yourself, then you'll have it, and it'll open for you, just, you know, a downloaded file. You don't have to wait for it then when you get here. Okay? I won't talk this much every week. Yes, ma'am. I can't hear you. I'm sorry, Marie. The bulletin stuff is also on the website. If you look for it, it'll say Parish Bulletin, and you'll be able to open that too. And we are able to, after Mass, you're the first people that can get bulletins since all this started. So after Mass, as you're leaving the church, ushers will be able to pass out bulletins because they're going to be wearing gloves. So they can give those to you as you leave the church. So be sure you get one. Okay, I think that's it. So I'm going to invite you to please stand.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, in our second reading today, Paul urges us to conduct ourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. For the times we have failed to act in a Christ-like manner, let us turn to the Lord and seek his mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, in your kingdom, the first shall be last, and the last shall be first. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will not forsake those who turn to you in need. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are just in all your ways and abounding in compassion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God.
God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbors, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me. And I do not know which I shall choose. I'm caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foremen, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So this parable really doesn't seem very fair at all. You know, in this parable, it could have been a lot different if he would have paid the five o'clock people first. I mean, last. If he'd have paid the people that started in the morning, if he'd have paid them first, then they would have had no idea that the 5 o'clock people that started working had received the same usual daily wage. But that would defeat the point of his parable, because he's comparing the kingdom of God to this parable. Jesus is saying that the kingdom of God is a place where God is incredibly generous. You know, we heard in Isaiah's first reading that God, the Lord said, my ways are so much above your ways. Your ways are not my ways. Our way is you work 10 hours a day, you get 10 hours of pay. You work 1 hour of a day of work, you only get 1 hour. And you pay those that have been there the longest. But Jesus is saying it's not like that in God's eyes. If you put yourself in the shoes of the early morning laborers, think about how they felt. Well, at first they would have felt very happy that they got hired to go work in the vineyard, because that's how a lot of them were able to work, was they would go out and they would hope that somebody would choose them to go to work that day, and they would get paid at the end of the day so that they could have enough money to buy food to feed their family. So the stronger people would get picked first. And then once they get all that they need, then the rest of them don't have any work. So they're going out and they're working, but then they see more people coming out and working at 10, at noon, at 3. And they're like, where are all these people coming from? And then at 5. And then at 6, when it's time to come get their pay, if you went to work early in the morning, you're thinking, wow, I worked hard. And then you see the landowner give those people that reported last, a full day's wage. What would be your thoughts? Well, that's not fair. Oh, wait, we're probably going to get a lot more. Yeah. But then you see the people that went out at 3 o'clock and they get the full day's wage, nothing more. And then you start thinking, wait a minute. Then the noon, and they get a full day's wage. And you're going, wait, this isn't fair. This is so not just. And so by the time they get paid, they're furious. But this isn't about wages. This is about God's generosity. This is about entering into the kingdom of heaven. You know, in the early church, there was no such thing as confession. And if you were baptized as a Christian, then your sins were all forgiven. But if you sinned, namely, if you denied that you're a Christian to the Romans who were torturing Christians, then you would be in trouble. So a lot of the early Christians postponed their baptism because they wanted to make sure that they were going to heaven. And some of those early Christians were seeing these waiting to be baptized, going out like St. Augustine before his baptism, where they're going out and they're living this life and they're doing all kinds of what they think is fun stuff, even though it's sinful. And they're a little jealous. And so we have to be careful not to be envious and jealous in our life. We have to think about God's ways, not our ways. How does God see this world? God does not just look down and smile on Kansas City or Belton. God does not just sit down and smile upon the United States. God smiles down upon this whole world, every city, every country, every person. And so God's ways are hard for us to imagine because we tend to define ourselves as Americans or as Kansas Cityans, and we're always comparing ourselves to others. And we develop enemies because we do have enemies in this world. But that's not how God sees it. And so what we have to do is ask God to help us to see how he sees. Because he loves every single person, good or bad. And his goal is that those 5 o'clock people
can receive salvation too, because he wants all his children to return home to heaven. Not just me or you. And it's like the parable of the lost sheep. You know, when that sinful lost sheep is finally found, there's great joy. When one sinner repents, there is so much joy in heaven. It doesn't mean that we're getting less because we're being better. It means that we have to rely on God, and even though we may feel like we deserve to be first, it's a very human way to think, being last in heaven is still the greatest thing in the world as being first, because we're there. So think about that. God's ways are not our ways. They're much more generous, merciful, kind, and forgiving than we are. But our job here on earth is to grow into that. So think about that this week. Help me to see your justice versus how I think justice should be. Would our catechist please stand? Just the catechist. Oh, we got some new teachers. Okay, we have one here. All right. So this is the catechetical weekend, catechetical Saturday/Sunday. And so for the pastoral activity of the church, the cooperation of a great many people is needed so that communities as well as individuals may advance to full maturity in the faith and continually show forth their faith through the celebration of the liturgy, through study, and through their manner of life. So in this celebration, we will bless the name of the Lord for giving us such co-workers and pray that through the Holy Spirit, they will receive the grace they need to serve in our church. Do you want to come up, Sonia? Okay, all right. So now I ask you, are you willing to exercise the ministry of catechesis here at St. Sabina? With the help of, okay, may God help you to be good stewards to what has been entrusted to you, and may you and all the catechists who serve in this parish receive the grace you need for your service here at St. Sabina. So now let us all stand and renew our own baptismal promises, which we promise to serve God and our holy church. So I ask you all, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
I do. Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
I do.
That's a little pause there, people. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is our faith in our church. We are proud to profess it. So now we trust in the boundless generosity of God. Let us bring all of our needs before our God.
For the church, may we welcome all who come to the Lord's vineyard, whoever they are and whatever the hour. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments all over the world, may they promote the common good and be transparent to the people whom they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For catechists, may they be blessed with creativity, wisdom, and enthusiasm as they guide our parish children and youth along the path of faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater care of the earth, that God will heal the damage done to ecosystem, free us from narrow vision, and help us to change the ways that we misuse God's gift of nature. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering, that God will heal the sick, bring comfort to those who are isolated, give strength to those fleeing violence, and hope to those seeking jobs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this parish community, may we be the gospel's model of community in which there are neither first nor last, but only sisters and brothers in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are approaching death and those who have died, especially Bill Myers, may they ever proclaim that to live in is Christ and to die is gain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of life, you have made us in your image and given us work to do in caring for and stewarding creation. Hear our prayers that we might respond to your call in our lives to serve you and others. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Sala in the
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you humbly. We pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your children. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof.
By the way, say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Of God.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please remember. Please put your kneeler down in the pew in which you are sitting, then we know where to clean. Thank you.